Hi everyone, thanks for joining us today. Today we're going to be walking everyone through how to conduct combination wave surge testing to IEC 61000-4-5 using our Compact NX5, which you'll find in front of you right here. The model we're using for today's video is going to be the BSP-1-400-16. So it is configured for burst, surge, as well as power failure, and does have a 400 volt 16 amp AC-DC coupler. You will see it is slightly larger than the 300 volt models. So for today's video, we're going to show everyone how to make the connections to the front side of the unit, following that to the back side, and then we'll go ahead and set up the display, modifying some testing parameters through the front panel. Then we'll go ahead and start up the IEC.Control software and modify some different testing criteria on there as well. Okay, so now let's go ahead and let's start with some of the connections on the front side of the unit. Okay, so we've just kind of got a little closer look at the top side of the Compact NX5. On the left side over here, you'll find your USB input on the left side of the screen. Following that, the display, you have your test on as well as a turnstile that's going to allow you to toggle through some of the menus. Following that, a couple different buttons, back, start, pause, as well as stop. Following that, you'll find your monitoring ports for both voltage and current, as well as your trigger. You will find just to the right of that your burst out. This is going to be commonly used for capacitive coupling clamps as well as some external CDNs. Following that, you'll find your EUT or DUT equipment under test or device under test supply, which you'll find right here. This is going towards your EUT or DUT. You will also find a couple different connections just to the right of that. I think you should be able to see them right there, there, and then down at the bottom right there. That's going to be your ground reference. Okay, so that should just about wrap up the front side here. Let's go ahead and turn around and show you some of the connections you'll need to make to the back side. Here you're going to find the back side of your Compact NX5. Starting from our left side, you'll see your EET supply input. Following that, your output for your surge. Then your power for your Compact NX5, as well as your toggle switch to turn it on. You'll find a couple different monitoring ports, as well as triggers and stuff like that right here. And then kind of working our way right, you'll find a couple different adapters here. These are going to be for USB as well as Ethernet. So today we're going to be using that to control our Compact NX5 via the IEC.Control software. Okay, so that should be just about it for the backside of the EM Test NX5. Let's go ahead and turn it around, get a little closer look at the display, and go ahead and modify some testing parameters through the front panel. Here you're going to find the front panel display for your Compact NX5. You will see a couple different options that are available to you here. You will see EFT or burst, combination wave surges, magnetic field testing, as well as power failure. Today we're really only concerned with surge testing, so let's go ahead and click on that. Here you're going to find the generic menu for surge testing. Today we're going to go ahead and click on quick start. And let's go ahead and change some of the different criteria within the quick start menu. So let's go ahead and change the voltage from 2 kV to 3 kV. All right, so we're going to go ahead and enter 3 kV right here. And when you're satisfied that the number you entered is where you want it to be, all you have to do is hit OK. All right, you'll see that change on the screen right there. Let's change the polarity from negative to positive. And let's change that. It just kind of drops down right there. And let's change the line synchronization from 90 to 180 degrees. All right. Now let's say we're ready to begin testing now. We've made the changes in the pulse that we wanted to make. All you have to do is hit that start button just below the toggle. Okay, so now let's go ahead and let's go back to our main surge menu here. Let's take a look at some of the standards. So here you're going to find some of the common ones used for the Compact NX5. You'll find IEC 61000-4-5, as well as a couple others on there. Today we're going to go ahead and select IEC 61000-4-5, edition 3, all levels, power. Okay, here you're going to find the menu for IEC 61000-4-5 within the kind of standard section. Let's go ahead and change them from level 4 to level 3. And you will see the level change indicated on the bottom with a pop-up as well. That should be just about it today for modifying some of the testing criteria from the front panel. Let's go ahead and get everything connected to our laptop, and we'll go ahead and show everyone how to change some different criteria through the IEC.Control software. Okay, so we just finished up walking everyone through changing some of the different criteria through the front panel of your Compact NX5. Now we're going to go ahead and we're going to show everyone how to set up your IEC.Control software with your Compact NX5, and then we're going to go ahead and show you how to change some different testing criteria, modifying some of the different pulses.
So the first section is going to be setting up your Compact NX5 with your IEC.Control software, just to be sure they are communicating correctly. So now let's go ahead and start with that. Let's go ahead and click on Setup in the upper left-hand corner. You're going to click on General right there. And you will notice a couple different options are available here. Today we're really only concerned with the mode. Now if you are installing this software on your own personal computer, the simulation or software only will probably be selected. You want to be sure you are selecting Test System right there. And you'll see that we already have that selected today. And you're going to go ahead and hit OK. When you do select this, you'll see this menu pop up, and you will see remote indicated on the Compact NX5. It should be on the front panel display. All right, so now that we do have the remote connection to our IEC.Control software, now we have to input all the information for our device. So we're going to go ahead and go to Setup again. We're going to click on Device, which is the second item here on this dropdown. You will notice that we already have our Compact NX5 entered. However, we are going to show you how to do that today as well. So the devices is a drop down right here. You can go ahead and select a wide variety of different devices. However, like we mentioned earlier today, we are using our Compact NX5. So we're going to go ahead and click Compact NX5. You will notice a little menu right here next to our Compact NX5. This is just going to be the Compact NX5's license information as well as the serial number. And if you're running the Compact NX5 test system from us, we'll provide a USB drive that's going to have this license code as well as the serial number indicated on it. It's going to make it really easy just to enter that quickly. All right, so once you have that entered in here, all you have to do is hit OK. All right, so now we should be good with the license. Now we're going to have to figure out the interfacing between our IEC.Control software and our Compact NX5. So the same kind of methodology, you just click this little menu just to the right of it. You will notice two different options for your interface setup, USB or Ethernet. As we mentioned previously, we are using the OptoLink converter, so this is going to be USB. The easiest way to do this is to hit the search button in the lower left corner. And you will see Compact NX5 found. And this is going to automatically identify which port it is connected to. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to hit yes. And you will see the port COM3 is indicated for us today. So we're satisfied with that. We're going to go ahead and hit OK. And then you should see an OK button here at the bottom as well. So that should be all you should have to do for this interface right here, which is just the device setup. All right, we're going to let it load up here in just a minute. Okay, so now if you look down the lower right-hand corner, you will see Compact as well as a little icon. This is just indicating that our Compact NX5 is connected with our serial number indicated there as well. All right, so now let's go ahead and let's take the second half of the video here, and we're going to walk through a little bit about the interface as well as changing some pulses. Okay, so now that we walk through how to get everything communicating, let's take a look at the software interface quickly. Here you're going to find your generic start screen for your IEC.Control software. So there's two different main modes you can look at here up in the upper left corner. That's going to be your standards mode and your device mode. Let's go ahead and click on our standards mode first. Let's look at power supply AC. All right, so let's take a look at part 5, which is going to be a combination wave surge. Okay, so the standards mode is going to be a great place to start if you're looking to do testing for IEC 61000-4-5 or kind of basing those criteria off the standard. So you will notice a couple different options here on the left side you can modify to change some of the different aspects of the pulse. You can see right there the voltage as well as the phase angle. Kind of looking here, you will see kind of a generic pulse indicated on the screen. That's going to show you those different criteria. Kind of working our way right here, you will see the selection kind of menu right here. This is going to be a really quick and easy way to change the different test levels. So let's go ahead and let's select test level 3 for today. All right, and you will see that indicated here as well at the bottom, line to line and then line to earth. One more area that you do want to take a note of here is going to be your pulse shape. So this is just indicating the generic shape of the pulse. Okay, so then when you're ready to begin testing, all you have to do is hit the start button right here. We're not going to be doing any testing today, so we're just going to close this menu out. Now let's go ahead and look at our device mode right here. And we're going to click on Surge once again. Okay, so this menu does allow you to make a little bit more modifications on here as well. you will see some different options that were grayed out or otherwise not available. So you will see the same kind of criteria: voltage, phase angle, synchronization, polarity, and these are more modifiable than you would be able to do that through the standards menu. So if you kind of want to customize your pulses a little bit more, this is a great way to do that. When you do customize your pulse and you want to save it, all you have to do is hit save in the lower right-hand corner right there, and you can save it with a comment. You can pull it up again later. So the same kind of menu criteria, a little different here because the test levels aren't gone, but you will see the pulse shape. We have the 1.2 by 50 microseconds and 8 by 20. So when you are ready to begin testing, all you have to do is hit the start button in the lower left-hand corner. We're not actually going to conduct any testing today because we don't have anything hooked up. So we're going to go ahead and hit the X button. Okay, so that should just about wrap it up. We appreciate everyone taking the time to walk through the Compact NX5 and modifying some parameters both through the front panel display and the IEC.Control software. Feel free to reach out to us if you're ever in need of any rental Compact NX5 test systems or any decoupling networks. Thank you.